welcome to the show. My name is Anisha with a T. You're watching Urban Television and it is Living Right Here, One and One. Well, today I have a young gentleman with him. He started at the age of 12 with Swangs Avenue, left Swangs, then he continued with his studies, flew up to Nairobi, came back home, and he's working on his music. He goes by the name of, he was Young Z.
You don't know, it's Zagazillion, formerly Young Z. That's Wagwan. Yeah.
Like I said, you started off at the age of 12, you're very young. Tell us the advantages of starting off in the business when you're young.
I got a lot of experience recording songs in studio because I used to love going to studio every weekend. I used to go to Swangs every single weekend and I would make a song. So it really helped me with that and like some shows here and there. I got my feet wet, you know.
Who inspired you? You just sat down one day and you're like, you know what, I want to switch things up. Or someone sat down and like, you know what, you need to change this up.
Okay, well, it's happened when I wasn't really doing my music. I was just chilling with my friends at school in Nairobi. And he was telling me change my Insta handle to something else. It was just my regular name, Zachary Mukiza. So he said, do something like Zagazillionaire. I'm like, man, what the hell? So I chopped it. I was like, Zagazillions.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now you set it off you set it off in the music industry at the age of 12. That's a very young age. You don't get people doing that. Because most times will tell you, I first went to school and I finished my SWAT and then, you know, I broke up. But you set it off at the age of 12. And you told me your dad was a big push.
Yeah.
You have cool parents, I have to say. You have very cool parents. You have to thank God.
Yeah.
Now, what are the advantages that you got from the from starting off in the music industry at a tender age?
Okay, I got to practice like my skills as an artist. I would go to studio, like when I was at Swangs anyway, I would go to studio every weekend, every single weekend. I swear, you can ask Ben on all of them. And I would make a song every time. So I really loved that. And also like the few shows I got, it helped me, you know, at that
build
time.
Yourself as a person. So we have to say that you're not a baby in this, you know, that's the reason as why you've started your own record label company. Please tell us about that name and how you started it.
Well, okay. my company is called UGANDA Records. Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. It's a company started by me, Zagazillions, and Ilji is my producer. He's back over there.
Yeah,
we started this thing, man, and we're pushing. It's just me and him. Also, shout out to Andy Music. He's also helping us.
Yeah.
And yeah, we're the hottest, youngest flyers. We do our thing. We have a new genre. We don't do anything else that people do. I hate copying. So
yeah.
I came up with my own genre. It's called Zaga Vibe.
Zaga Vibe. Can you give us an acapella of that?
Okay. Let me think of something.
Yeah.
One Zagazillion. Legendary, like Jose Camillion. like Davido, I want 30 billion. So I'm small, you know?
Yeah.
I'm not, I'm a rapper, but I'm not like a traditional MC.
Mm.
I don't do the whole, you know, Nas, Tupac, all that. Even though those are people, I listen to some of their songs, but that's not my style. Like, I'm not the best freestyler, but I can make a hit.
Oh, nice one.
Yeah.
So how are you balancing school and music?
Okay, I'm about to finish school and I'm in year 13. So I'm about to finish, so it's not such a big deal. And even my main focus, it has always been music. Always, above everything, it's always music. I just go to school to like, you know, to finish an education of some sort so that I have it at least. But I don't believe in plan B's or anything like that because I know that this is going to pay off. For me, it's always music.
I asked him actually before we went on, I was like, where do you see yourself in 10 years? He's like, nah, where do I see myself in 3 years?
Yeah.
Where do you see yourself in 3 years?
3 years are going to be the biggest thing out here and we're going to be way bigger like this. We're going to have chains. More eyes, you know, more success, fans everywhere doing amazing things bigger than Uganda, you know. I'm really pushing hard, like you guys have no idea.
You're working hard, Hard work usually pays off, but also hard work with a mix of talent, you know.
Yeah.
So do you consider yourself as the most talented? Because, you know, sometimes I have people on the show that tell you, you know, Anisha, I probably don't have the best vocals.
Yeah.
But I can switch things up, you understand?
Yeah.
I'm giving them a different vibe. And you just talked about that your new type of music that's just not everyone's ordinary kind of thing, you understand?
Yeah.
How do you feel the public will will they understand? You know how Ugandans are, if kadongo kamo, if it's not like, ah, just like a million and some, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you feel that they're ready, Uganda is ready for this big change of music?
Well, even if they're ready or not, it's coming.
They need to be ready because, like, before when we're having this the conversation, I talked about the fact that, it's good to first start off from home and have a big fan base. Yeah. And you can hit off and become international.
Of course, of course.
So if they're not ready, if they don't...
You make them ready. When will they ever be ready? Yeah. You have to make them ready.
You're very brilliant.
It's true.
You're very intelligent.
You have to force it down their throat, man. I'm telling you.
So your plan is
And it's not like it's work. I'm not forcing something work to you. I'm forcing, amazing.
Good music.
Like, you just have to accept it in your soul,
Yeah. That it's part of you.
Yeah.
So let's talk about a little about you. I want you to give them the schools you've gone to. Do you have a girlfriend? Do you have a baby mama? I'm asking because, these generations, you just never know, Someone might be 18 that they started having babies at 16. Together, so we need to know.
I don't have a baby mom. I don't have no kids either. I don't have a girlfriend as well. I went to Rainbow International School for 12 years. Then I went to ISU. Then I went to Hillcrest. Then I went to, and these are in Nairobi, Hillcrest in Nairobi International. Then I also went to GEMS in Nairobi for like 1 month. Then I came back here to Rainbow, where I am at right now.
Back home.
Yeah, yeah.
That's it. But when we're talking earlier on, you talked about your friends in Nairobi. I think Nairobi played a big impact on you.
Yeah.
You met a lot of people who changed your life. Yeah. And you talked about how you have your two friends and you told yourselves that, you know what, we are going to be big. We are going to focus on our career.
Exactly.
So tell us about your experience in Nairobi as a young artist.
Well, in Nairobi, I wasn't really doing no music. I was just living my life.
I like that.
I wasn't on the music thing because there I could not focus. I was in a school, man. There were like girls everywhere. I had my friends who were the most popular guys in the school.